something for your name. Ryan Prince, Mr. and Mrs. McLaughlin.
I'd like to welcome you all here tonight to celebrate the marriage of Michael and Ashley. They're well suited. Michael's a great lad. We don't have to accept Michael in the family. He was accepted from day one. He's a great lad. We have plenty of respect for him. He always looked after Ashley no matter where the man. There's one person I would really like to say thank you to, is Ashley's grandfather, Mr. Andrew Tosh. Without your help, you really made things go here today, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. You're a great man. On behalf of my wife and I, we'd like to thank you all for coming here today and sharing our special day with us. We hope that you're enjoying it every bit as much as we are, and we'd like to thank you for your kind wishes, cards, presents and support. I want to thank Ivy and George. I want to say thank you to Ivy and George, sorry. Your contribution to today has been amazing. You have literally given everything to this wedding. Generosity is second to none, and this day wouldn't have been possible without you. I want to thank you for taking me into the family and treating me as one of your own. It really has meant a lot to me. And most importantly, I thank you for raising such a beautiful and amazing daughter. And I promise to... I promise to do everything I can to make her as happy for the rest of our lives. I'd like to thank Ashley's granddad Andy also for his contribution and generosity. It really means a lot to us. I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank my own parents, Jimmy and Bernie, for everything they've done for me over the past 28 years and making me the man that I am. Okay, moving on to the best men and groomsmen. I would like to take this opportunity to thank you for your support and friendship, especially my best friend and one of the best men, Dan Murphy. The effort and thought put into the both stag parties were brilliant, and I couldn't have had a better time. Becca, Vicky, Carly and Danielle, you all looked beautiful today, and I'm sure everyone here would agree. Absolutely stunning. Yeah. Finally, moving on to the most important person in this room today, and that's me going to start crying again here. Most important person in this room today and of my life, my beautiful wife, Ashley. Doesn't she look absolutely stunning today? I couldn't be more proud today to have you as my wife. For those who know me well and know Ashley well, she's a nickname on my phone, and that's Princess. And today, Ashley, you really are. There are many words I could just use to describe you. You're smart, caring, loyal, family-orientated, hard-working, beautiful. I could be here all day. You've been the most supportive person I've ever met, always there for me and always pushing me to better myself. And I can't thank you enough for that. Can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. I cannot wait to start our own family, as you will be a great mother, just like you are a great auntie to all your nieces and nephews. I also want to thank you for working tirelessly over the past 2 years to make this day, special as it is. You've done a fantastic job, and I'm so proud of you. With that in mind, folks, I would like you all to be standing and raise your glasses to the biggest toast of the day, please. My beautiful wife, Ashley.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm David, Michael's brother and best man. For those of you who do, I'm sorry. I've never been a best man before, and I'm not exactly renowned for my speech writing. So please bear with me, because Michael promised if I do a good job today, He said I could be best man at his next wedding too. The crowd gathered in this room today, right now, on this very special day, is testament to the love that we all have for Michael and Ashley, as well as the love they have for each other. I think it's time for a few toasts. What do you think? Just a few, mind. I don't want anybody drunk by the time I finish. I'm looking at you, Bernie. Michael has always been a fantastic brother, a brilliant friend, and someone I'll always love and admire. I have no doubt that he'll also be a fine husband to Ashley, just so long as he does as he's told. It has been said that marriage is not about finding a person you can live with, it's about finding that one person you can't live without. On this incredible day, we all know in our hearts that Michael and Ashley have found each other.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. And that window's look at isn't that high. And I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. I wonder.
Thank you.